I feel like I gotta be my best because I'm sitting next to Jacque Reid.
You have to.
Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. Best known as the former lead anchor on BET Nightly News, our next guest is an Emmy award-winning journalist who has been at the forefront of social issues, breaking glass ceilings and setting the standard for women in television to blaze a trail for a new generation. And with no signs of slowing down, she continues to be a trendsetter on air and online. Please welcome my fellow Atlanta, sorry, Decatur native, Jacque Reid.
Great to be here
with you. I love the show
and I love you all.
Thank you. We're so happy. We're definitely so happy, especially today being national TV talk show host day. We got the one and only Jacque Reid here. Let's take it all the way back to Decatur.
Where's Greater?
East Ash, shout out to Southwest Cam High School. We both
are going to do it.
How did you even get started in the field of journalism?
Would you believe it started at Southwest DeKalb?
Wow, me too.
Yep, because I was a reporter for the newspaper there, and the teachers there encouraged me, because I was a good English student, to lean into that, to do more. And so when I got to college at Clark Atlanta University, HBCU, I decided to continue that, focus on journalism. Then I went to graduate school at Northwestern University. And polished things up there, and then I was off to the races. Not 2 months after I graduated, you know, I got my first job in Brunswick, Georgia.
Come on, Brunswick is north
of Jacksonville, south of Savannah, very small town, but you know, you got to cut your teeth and kind of make your mistakes and, you know, work your way up. So I did local news and I got to BET. And you know, the rest is history.
Beautiful thing. Well, let's switch our gears for just a second and talk
about the midterm elections. So midterm elections coming up in less than two weeks from now. And we see a lot of women, and not only women, but women of color that are nominated on all levels. How do you predict the outcome to be?
Well, you know, I have to say, I'm not a political expert like my play cousin, Joy Reid. We have a podcast together. She's a political expert, but I do follow the news, and there are a lot of great black women, particularly here in Georgia. Stacey Abrams running for governor here. There's Lucy McBath. I had to write them all down. There's so many running for Congress in Georgia here. Letitia James in New York is running for attorney general. She'd be the first black female attorney general in the state of New York. Juliana Stratton, lieutenant governor in Illinois. She's running for that. The list goes on and on, but here's the thing that we have to do.
Okay.
So as black women, we got to be on our game this midterm election. Not only do we have to be registered and ready to vote, but we have to call our friends, our girlfriends, our hairstylists, people, cousins, and, you know, I don't live in Georgia, but I'm talking to everybody that I know in Georgia. Because black women are the determining factor. Remember Doug Jones in Alabama, right? Who ran for Senate there? It was black women that made the decision and made the difference there. So black women, again, are working in key parts across this nation, getting people to register. That's over now, but getting people to get to the polls. And despite what's going on out there to disenfranchise voters, you got to get out there, and you got to, you have to be posting on your social media every day. Vote. Don't forget to vote. Get out there and encourage people. Can't be, you know, can't be apathetic right now.
Now, Jacque, as an accomplished journalist, what is your take on the attack on the press, saying that you all are basically, well, all we are basically fake news?
Yeah, it's dangerous, and it's every day. Every day. I'm shocked at the things that comes out of this man's mouth, being Trump. And I think that if it goes unchecked, not just by journalists, but by his fellow Republicans, if he allows them to continue to attack the press, and because his followers believe whatever he says, he believes that what we're saying is fake news. And journalists are here to inform people so they can make better decisions. If you take that away, it's a huge problem in this country, worse than what's going on right now.
Well, let me ask you, do you think that social media plays a part in that? Do you think that they cause the crisis for the credibility for news and true news sources?
I don't think it's just social media. I think it's the popularity of people who aren't journalists that people think are giving them information. People like that that gossip. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? People that are out there and known for gossip, people lean to them and look to them for information, and a lot of times it's misinformation.
Yeah,
I tell my journalism students that I work with, when I tell them to research something for me, I say go to credible news sources.
Yeah. Yes.
Do not go to gossip websites
right.
that are not going to check and double check their facts and their sources in order to make sure that they're bringing you credible news. But that's all a part of journalism and people getting information and knowing that everything everybody puts out there isn't the truth.
Yeah, right. Yeah. Let's talk a little bit about celebrities kind of taking a stand. Rihanna, Amy Schumer with her latest post. Congratulations to her on her upcoming childbirth.
Yeah.
And she just announced that. But what is your take on celebrities taking a stand? And do you think their influence matters?
I think it does. Mm-hmm. You know, like it or not, celebrities are influential. Mm-hmm. People listen to and lean into what they're saying and what they're doing. They want to live their lives like them, and they want to listen to what they're saying. The good thing is that a lot of celebrities are out there, Beyonce, so many others, seeing that there's more than just enjoying their riches.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
They have a responsibility
right.
as public figures to make sure that they're making their fans, who may not be tuning into news and things like that, aware mm-hmm. of important things that's going on in this country.
Mm-hmm.
And so I think it is great that celebrities are doing it, and I think that they should do more of it because they're citizens at the
yeah.
end of the day,
yes.
just like you
yes.
and me.
Yes.
You know what I mean? The laws of this land affect them just like they do the rest
That's
of us.
Awesome, awesome. Well, you know, we're gonna have to keep Jacque for one more segment, so
yes.
stay exactly where you are. We'll be right back with Sister Circle Live.
You are so-
Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. We are still continuing our conversation with
yes.
the one and only Jacque
yes.
Reid.
Now, Miss Jacque,
yes.
I am a natural hair connoisseur.
And beautiful
hair. Mm-hmm. Isn't it gorgeous?
I have been natural since 2003. Mm-hmm. And I've gone through different scenarios with my hair. But I didn't find the freedom until just recently, the recent years, to really wear my own hair
mm-hmm.
because
so
the
pretty.
Industry kind of makes you feel bad mm-hmm. about wearing your natural hair as black women.
Yes.
And I see a wave of it happening, you know, even in journalists are
yeah.
wearing their natural
yeah.
hair. And like just on television, you see commercials now, women have natural
mm-hmm.
hair. What do you think is due to this? What is the cause of this progress?
Mm-hmm.
You know, why is it now acceptable for us to be ourselves? And sometimes, why is it still not acceptable for us mm-hmm. to be ourselves?
Well, I mean, I think that a lot of times, if you want to get a certain job in journalism or in entertainment as an actress, you have to wear your hair a certain way. We most mm-hmm. recently saw Viola Davis kind of
mm-hmm.
stop it with the weaves on the red carpet
yes.
and wear her natural hair. And more women in TV news are wearing natural hair. Listen, I would love to have natural hair, but what you can't do on TV is the transition.
Mm-hmm.
And we all
thing.
Know what it is. If you cut it, let it grow out, what's my coil gonna be? What products am I gonna use? You can't do that on TV, and every day you're gonna show up with a different look. Oh, I remember that. That's freshly permed. I need a perm right now. That was a fresh perm. But you know what I mean? You can't do that on TV.
Yeah.
You can't do that when you're on every day. So am I going to wear wigs? For me, I'm trying to figure out, how am I going to do this transition? Am I going to cut it all off,
mm-hmm.
you know, all off
mm-hmm.
and grow it? So
yeah, that's what me and Trina going through that
you know,
right now. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
yeah.
I have to wear protective wigs right now, though, because,
yeah.
you know, all the heat that was happening every
yes.
day. You know, my natural curl was deteriorating. It was just going away. And I was like, wait, what happened?
Yeah.
yeah.
And my stylists get mad at me because on TV every day, I'm like, don't put heat in my hair. Don't.
Oh,
stop. Stop.
I don't play the radio when heat.
I know.
You can't.
You can't.
And use your hands
it just
to comb.
Ruins it.
I don't
yes.
even want to comb.
Well, Jacque, I want to talk to you about your newest projects. What
yeah.
do you have going on now?
Oh, my goodness. I have a podcast with
yeah.
Joy Reid called
yes.
Read This, Read That. She's my
yes.
play cousin. and there we are.
Love
and
it.
We do it once a week. You can find it iTunes, everywhere. We have so much fun talking. You know, Joanne is known, of course, you know, as the political cousin, but
yes.
she
yes.
is so much fun and does all these accents and things like we have so much fun.
So
we
much
talk
fun.
About our real lives, and we have mm-hmm. wine.
Oh,
fabulous. Yeah.
All right.
My own podcast.
I can't
wait
to get out of here without yeah. just asking, how's it going with your love life?
You know what?
You're single.
Here's the thing.
I am
not married. I don't have kids. And the thing that I always say about this, and I always get in trouble for saying it, but women have to break free of this conditioning and brainwashing. where we believe that in order to be happy and fulfilled and have a meaningful life, that we have to have a husband and that we have to be mothers. Everybody is not meant to be married. Mm-hmm. Everybody not is meant not meant to be a mother, which is why we so see so many kids being abused and neglected.
That's right.
Because motherhood is hard.
Yes, it is hard.
And I'm saying that as someone that's not a mother. I'm glad my mother did it. Thank you, Mom. I know she's watching. But you know what I mean?
We got to
do
it. Give it up for Jacque Reid. You can hear Jacque's podcast, Read This or Read That, on iTunes, and her podcast, Inside Her Story, on Sirius XM Radio. Tomorrow, the Campbells will be at the Circle. And Warren Campbell. Have a great day, everybody.